African rice fields are ideal malaria vector breeding sites. These vectors are actually one of the main reasons why Africa suffers from 85% of the world's malaria mortality. It was actually thought that rice farmers did not have more malaria, even though there were more mosquitoes nearby. And this was probably because rice farmers were wealthier and therefore better protected against mosquitoes. We reassessed this and found that nowadays, with better intervention coverage and equity across Africa, that rice actually does bring more malaria. This sets up a clash between the agricultural and health sector. Whilst the agricultural sector is trying to increase rice production, the health sector is trying to eliminate malaria. Our research found that 1 hectare of rice is capable of producing 5 million malaria vectors during a rice growing season. To reduce this number, there needs to be strong collaborations between medical entomologists and agronomists. This collaboration would mean that malaria vector abundance should automatically be included into regular rice research. Our intersectoral collaborations currently are establishing techniques to produce good rice yield whilst reducing malaria vector abundance. One such technique is alternate wetting and drying irrigation, which is able to reduce methane and water consumption too. To scale our outcomes, further detailed research will help us figure out exactly how each rice growing operation, like fertilizer application and irrigation timing, best minimizes mosquito breeding and mosquito numbers. Then we need to test that with different soil ecologies to enable scalability. This research has the potential to produce a win-win-win solution that addresses agricultural, climate, and health problems all at once. The kind of solutions that we would need to achieve our global goals.